an act to amend the Nigerian Ports Authority Act, CAP N126, LFN 2004, to provide for establishment of the Araromi Seafront Port in Ilaje Local Government, Ondo State, through 2021, in bracket SB 684. I'm Senator Nicholas Tofowomo, representing Ondo South. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, I'm very optimistic and delighted to lead the debate on this economic-oriented bill, which seeks to amend MPA Act to provide for the establishment of a seaport in Araromi Seafront in Ilaje Local Government of Ondo State. You will recall that this bill was first read on the 24th of March 2021. Seaports have changed many countries all over the world, and many countries have used seaports to improve their importation and exportation business, and also develop their marine transportation. It will be interesting to know that there are 96 seaports in South Africa with a population of 60 million, meaning that 625,000 South Africans will have access to a seaport if distributed evenly. There are over 200 seaports in the United Kingdom with a population of 70 million, meaning that 350,000 Britons will have access to a seaport if evenly distributed. Also, there are 22 seaports in Morocco with a population of 37 million, meaning that 1.6 Moroccans will have access to seaports if distributed evenly. There are 15 seaports in Egypt with a population of 100 million. There are 360 commercial seaports in the United States of America with a population of 330 million. And there are 14 seaports in Italy with a population of 61 million. Libya has 15 seaports with a population of 7 million. There are 6 seaports in Ghana with a population of 32 million, meaning that one seaport in Ghana serves 5.3 million Ghanaians. While in Nigeria, with only 6 major seaports, indicating that a seaport in Nigeria serves 33.3 million Nigerians. That is not only sad, but unfortunate, and it is one of the key to our slow economic development. Our stand in the Ninth Senate is to move Nigeria forward economically and reposition Nigeria. In the field of global economy, Nigeria is overdue for a minimum of 20 major seaports, and we are still struggling with 6 seaports, which are as follows: Lagos Port Complex, Tincan Island in Lagos, Calabar Port, Delta Port, Rivers Port in Port Harcourt, and Onne Port. The Lagos Complex and the Tincan Island Port in Lagos are congested and overworked, serving Lagos State, Ogun State, Osun State, Ondo State, Kwara State, Kogi State, Ekiti State, and many other Nigerian states and other neighboring countries, which has built daily traffic congestion and had a significant importation and exportation delays of goods with additional cost to traders. The Araromi Seafront Port is strategically located on the Atlantic Ocean, of the Atlantic Ocean sea line, and it has a deep sea, what will accommodate large vessels? The port will play a very big role in the congesting Lagos seaport and serve 5 states, which include Ekiti State, Osun State, Kogi State, Edo State, and Ondo State, with other surrounding states. The seaport will give an end to illegal importation and exportation on our land borders, and all imported goods will be channeled through Lagos ports, and more revenue will be generated. The port will create employment for thousands of people and make clearing goods faster. Our coastal line in that region will develop and improve trade, commerce, and industry. A lot of seafront tourism will improve because it has white sand, like Britain in the United Kingdom. Araromi seafront port will improve agricultural products like cocoa, cassava, plantain, oil palm, and rubber. This will be easy to export and earn foreign exchange and improve our economy. Federal government is investing on railways through foreign loan. And in this regard, World Bank support will also help in establishing this seaport. And if properly managed, the seaport will fund itself and business opportunities will enhance to surrounding states. This will be a good innovation, and the funding will not affect our economy. The Nigerian Senate is well committed to developing Nigeria economy. And if we can embrace establishment of more seaports in Nigeria, our genuineness to economic development will be established. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, seaports have helped many countries to develop. And if we establish more seaports, our economy will improve. Importation and exportation will grow. Our coastal areas have been neglected. It will receive attention. Income generation will improve. Many government institutions will be extended to this new seaport. In conclusion, I want all my colleagues to support this bill, and let us drive establishment of more seaports in Nigeria, so that life will change and more jobs will be made available, and exploration of commercial goods would improve our revenue. In compliance with Order 73, Subsection 3, on the Senate Standing Order 2015, as amended, a compendium of financial implication on the bill is attached here. Mr. Senate President, sir, there are seven states on the seashore, and only five have seaports. Akwa Ibom, Bayelsa, Ondo State, we don't have seaports. If we can sort out these seaports before the end of this administration, it will be success. And I pray that my colleagues will support me. Thank you.
Very distinguished Senator Francis.
I rise to support this important bill of establishing a seaport in Ondo State, particularly Araromi, where we have this deep sea already. And I will urge my colleagues to see reasons with us on how to improve the economy. Number one, Araromi has a deep sea level that does not need dredging. So the federal government needs to just build the platform and the barges where the ship will anchor, very close to Atlantic Ocean. And two, Lagos is already decongested. Abis congested with the associated transportation problems provided by the few ports there. The only two ports in Lagos, Apapa and Tinka. If Araromi is joined very close to Lekki, we have enough space. And the congestion of Lagos will now be diverted to Ondo State, and Lagos will be free of trailer problem. Then it's very close to the north, particularly Kogi. And we have major importers in the north, particularly Kano, Kaduna, Maiduguri, and Sokoto, who normally patronize Lagos port because the alternatives are not there. Because of bad roads to Calabar port. Port Harcourt is congested already, despite the expansion they have there. So if Ondo is given the opportunity now, during our tenure here, automatically the economy will have enough space to breathe. Then we will curb excessive smuggling activities at the border. Because Nigerians, particularly from the north, because of the congestion here and the high cost of clearing, they patronize the Republic of Benin, Togo and Ghana at a very low cost. If Ondo is added, very close to Kogi, automatically it will be easier for the northern importers to move their goods without necessary distress from Lagos. Then the smuggling activities will come down. Then the economy will grow by providing employment opportunities for all the indigenous towards that side. If the employment opportunities are provided, then you will have that security will be alive.
Distinguished Memorando, please.
If all this, including the exportation of our Greek and mineral resources, are given facelift from Ondo through the IC to other countries, our foreign reserve will be better. Therefore, I urge my colleagues to approve this bill so as to ease the economic problem we have. Thank you very much.
You are here representing Ondo Central. Rise to strongly support this passage of this bill, Mr. President. And I also want to commend the sponsor of the bill, my colleague, Senator Nicola Tofowomo. It is a high time, Mr. President, that a seaport be established in Ondo State. Because of the advantages already enumerated by the sponsor of the bill and by Senator Fadahosin, without repeating what they have said, it is important at this time when the IGR of many states are dwindling. In fact, the federal government IGR is dwindling. And it is high time we look inward to ensure that we shouldn't be penny wise and pass foolish any longer, because we are endowed with a lot of resources. Deep sea port in Ondo State will enhance IGR of the federal government to a significant extent. And with this reward, Mr. President, I want to strongly support the passage of this bill so that Nigerians unemployment opportunities will be open. Thousands of youths will be employed. And again, commending Mr. President of the nation on his giant stride to ensure that railway lines are spread all over the nooks and crannies of Nigeria. With the establishment of a seaport in Ondo State, railway lines will be spread to all the adjoining, all the surrounding states, like Kogi, like Ilori, all of them, or Kwara. This will enhance, Mr. President, the revenue generation capacity of the federal government. I saw so.
Senator. My name is Senator Francis Ali Maken, representing the good people of Edo North. Mr. President, I rise to support this bill, which is economic driven. My contention is that this bill should also include Geregere Port in Edo State, because that one is natural. Because I like its own statistical analysis where they have where you now see even Ghana, which is small Ghana, has about 36 about 8 ports. But now in Nigeria, according to its own statistical data, which is very correct, Geregere Port is even going now, because the government of Edo State is trying to partner. So if we add a Geregere Port, which is a natural port right now, the NPA will not spend much money on it, because if you serve all the states of Delta, Anambra, and so on. So I rise to support that Geregere Port in Edo State should be included in this. Yes, in this bill.
Okay, the Sungwish, I think free advice. This one that you want to. At all, okay. No, this is not a motion, so you cannot just say you add. You can't add like that. You should pay for consultation. Senator Ibukule Amosun.